Hello everyone, welcome back to the course on Chemical Reaction Engineering 1. Myself, Neeti Mehta, Assistant Professor at Chemical Engineering Department, LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. So let's just start our today's session. Let's just start with our topic, which is non-ideal flow. Before starting today's topic, let us just have a quick recap of what we have covered in our previous sessions. Correct. So, we have discussed about what is non-ideal flow, what do we mean by RTD, how to determine RTD, and in the previous session, we have covered how to determine RTD in any given batch reactor or a plug flow reactor, correct? In case of any batch reactor or plug flow reactor, we have determined the formula for RTD measurement. We all know that in case of either a batch reactor or a plug flow reactor, the molecules will span the same span of time inside the reactor. Correct. So, whenever we are dealing with either a batch reactor or a PFR, the span of time spent by the molecules will remain the same. So, that was the basic fundamental theory behind derivation of RTD in batch and PFR reactor. Now, dealing with this CSTR. So, today we will discuss with CSTR how to determine RTD in CSTR. Correct. So, now talking about CSTR or MFR. So, CSTR is basically known as continuous stirred tank reactor, or another name for CSTR reactor is MFR, which is also known as mixed flow reactor. So, whenever we are talking about MFR reactor, we must understand that there will be a change in time span of individual reactant molecule or individual atoms and molecule inside the reactor. Correct. Again, I am repeating, whenever we are talking about a CSTR or an MFR reactor, the time spent by molecules or atoms inside the reactor are different. This is happening due to the fact that they will adopt different pathway to travel across the reactor. And due to this phenomena only, there will be different types of error which might generated, such as dead zone, or there may be possibility of channeling, or maybe a short circuiting. Correct. So there are number of parameters which are responsible in case of CSTR or MFR for non-ideal flow behavior or pattern. Right. So the first basic concept which we must understand and know whenever we are dealing with CSTR or MFR is the concentration of any substance in the outlet stream is considered to be identical throughout the reactor. Correct. So what we are assuming that the outlet concentration or the concentration of any product which is coming out of the reactor is equivalent to the concentration inside the reactor at any given point. But this is the ideal condition which is not possible in the real reactor or in real scenario. Correct. Next point is, in this particular derivation, we are going to assume that the tracer is injected using pulse injection method. So, what is pulse injection method? We have already covered, but again I am repeating here. So, in case of pulse injection method, what we are going to do is, we will take known amount of tracer and the tracer is either a radioactive material or any inert chemical substance. Correct. We'll take known amount of tracer and we will inject the entire quantity of that tracer at one shot inside the reactor. Once we do that, we will start our stopwatch and start noting down the outlet concentration with respect to time. So whatever concentration of tracer is coming out of the reactor at the given time interval, we will note it down, and using this particular concept we will determine the residence time of those tracer inside that particular reactor. Next is, in case of ideal reactor, we assume the uniform concentration throughout the reactor, but in real case this particular phenomena is not possible. So whenever we are inserting tracer inside an CSTR or MFR, we are assuming that it will show the ideal behavior. So with regard to that, we assume that the tracer will be distributed uniformly throughout the reactor. Correct. So this is the picture of an ideal CSTR. As you can see here, there is a CAN, that is inlet concentration of component A from topmost part of the reactor, and there is a CA out, which is outlet concentration of component A at the outlet stream. V is the volume of reactor and V0 will be the volumetric flow rate which we will be assuming. Correct. Now starting with the RTD study for MFR. So this is our reactor where we have taken CA in and CA out, and assuming V, capital V, as volume of our reactor. Now let's just start. The first assumption which we are doing is we are using a pulse injection method, and at time t equals to 0 we will insert known amount of tracer inside the reactor. Correct. Second is, in case of ideal reactor, concentration is assumed to be uniform throughout. This is our assumption, that in case of ideal CSTR or ideal MFR, the concentration is assumed to be uniform throughout. Right. So whenever we want to determine concentration of tracer, what we need to do is, we will simply do amount of tracer, right? So amount of tracer divided by total volume of reactor. That will give us the concentration of tracer. Correct. Amount of tracer upon volume of reactor will give us concentration of tracer inside the reactor. Is it clear? Now, coming to the next section, what we are going to do is, we will obey the mixed flow reactor and transient species balance, where we are saying that there is no reaction happening, right? We are assuming that there is no reaction happening. So what will happen if we do the material balance? It will be capital V dc upon dt equals to q c0 minus c. Correct. So V dc upon dt. Dc upon dt will give change in concentration of tracer with respect to time. And when you multiply concentration into volume, it will give you amount of tracer. Is it clear? So concentration multiplied by volume will give you amount of tracer. In the opposite side, we'll do Q, which is volumetric flow rate, C0, which is initial amount of concentration of tracer, minus C, which is concentration of tracer at a given time. Correct. In case of time which is greater than 0, what will happen when we are saying that time is greater than 0? So the value of C0 will be 0. Why it is so? just because at time greater than zero, the initial concentration of tracer will be zero because we are giving pulse input, and in case of pulse input, there is only one time injection possible. So you have just given the injection and then you have started your stopwatch. Correct. So when time is greater than zero, the value of C0 is zero. Now just separate out the variable and you will be getting it as CT equals to M by V exponential minus T by tau. Correct. Now what we need to do next is we need to determine RTD. We know the formula of RTD. For determining RTD, we have formula ET equals to CT upon 0 to infinite CT into DT. Correct. This is the formula for determining RTD of any given reactor. Correct. So what we will be doing here is we will substitute the value of CT in numerator and in denominator. We will simplify the terms and will get our desired RTD for MFR. So as you can see in this particular expression that in case of we need to just substitute CT value here and CT value here. So in case of numerator, we know the value of CT can be written as M by V exponential minus T by tau. Why? Just because the concentration of tracer in case of MFR is represented by this particular formula as we have derived right now. Correct. We have just derived this particular formula. So we will simply substitute this value in numerator here, and in for denominator, what we will be doing is we will simply integrate the value of CT from 0 to infinite. So it will be 0 to infinite M by V exponential of minus T by tau dt. Correct. Just put this value in numerator here and this particular value in denominator here. So you will be getting the value of this. Once you solve the integration and simplify the terms, you will get the value of ET as 1 by tau exponential of minus T by tau, where tau is the space time and T is the given time. Correct. So whenever we are talking about T equals to 0, whenever we are talking about the time equals to 0, so the value of RTD will be equivalent to 1 by tau. Correct. So this is all about RTD study in case of MFR or CSTR. So what we have done is we have simply started with material balance equation. We have determined the value in both the sides. We tried to determine the concentration of tracer, which is given by amount of tracer divided by volume of reactor. Right. So once we do that, we will simply use that concentration formula in RTD equation, which is RTD equation is given by ET equals to CT upon integration 0 to infinite CT dt. Correct. Integrate the terms, simplify numerator and denominator, you will get this particular equation. So this is all about RTD study in MFR and CSTR. You just need to remember this particular formula for your further calculations. Hope the things are clear. Thank you.